Every time I would see certain photographs of Summerwell's, I would get these downloads about the church and how the church is infiltrated purposefully by people seeking out children and or adults to prey upon and traffic. Let's compare and contrast the three ladies and see if there's any similarities or synergies.
Holy, holy moly. Like, my team is amazing. 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 Our team is a rock stars. And I am so excited.
I am so excited.
For the rapid growth in our team. Everyone's really been helping so many people this year get started. And it's been really awesome. So I'm grateful.
It's all in the symbology that's telling us what the company's about and what it's all about. Now let's compare and contrast Robin Lane, who is the pastor's wife, and the Watts case, Shanann Watts, and her friend Nichole Atkinson.
I do have an announcement. This is really exciting. I went yesterday to WHCB to record our commercial for
our Easter play that's coming up.
Nobody asked me to do it. I was really excited because I wanted to.
I'm shaking. I still get nervous. I lose my train of thought. I ramble.
Told you I was gonna ramble. I got it out of my system. I'm not in my head anymore. So thank you for listening. Thank you for popping on and watching me do what I do best.
Ramble.
So super excited.
It's just so obvious to me. I mean, that they all sound exactly the same. They use the same code words. Excited, and I'm so excited, and I'm just babbling, that it made me think of a song called Ramble On by Led Zeppelin. Does it seem like Shanann Watts, Nichole Atkinson, and Robin Lane have things in common? I heard the song Ramble On by Led Zeppelin pop in my head. And I don't know if you guys know this, but they are very, very, very strong magicians, aka musicians. Let's check out the lyrics. Mine's a tale that can't be told. My freedom I hold dear. How years ago, in days of old, when magic filled the air, 'twas in the darkest depths of mortar I met a girl so fair. But Gollum and the evil one crept up and slipped away with her. This lady, Robin Lane, who's the pastor's wife, literally held a prayer circle, church, temple. A temple is a triangle. A triangle is a pyramid. A pyramid is a temple. Are y'all catching on? And on the ninth week of Summer's disappearance, and did a prayer circle. And Summer was taken right before summer solstice. She's all up in the news, this lady. Anyway, it was like every time I would see certain photographs of Summerwell's, I would get these downloads about the church and how the church is infiltrated purposefully by people seeking out children and or adults to prey upon and traffic. That's where all the money's made up in the church, guys. So the sheep, the flock, are none the wiser. They don't know that they don't have to go to church to have a relationship with God. Go where the pretty pastor lady is word salading you to death, which basically means talking in circles so you have no clue what she's talking about, but she's saying it in a sweet voice, so, and she's pretty, so that must mean she's a good person. Meanwhile,
we have no clue what kind of people are in the church watching Summer, watching the kids.
Predator's main hunting grounds.
They've been steady promoting, getting all that tax-free dollar bills, y'all. Side eye.
And why would the parents be so sure that she was taken?
Summer Wells. And then her aunt was also a missing person.
Maybe they grew up in generational.
Ancient bloodlines.
They had another family member that was taken. They don't think the cases are connected. Obviously, there's a connection.
There's no such thing as a coincidence in a murder case or a missing person or a missing child case. Coincidences are leads. Any investigator will tell you that. Any good cop will tell you that. That's facts. Coincidences are leads. And it's a coincidence that two people and their family went missing. This whole case has got a very creepy aura around it.
Test every spirit. Test everything. Nothing is as it seems. And that the people that seem to be the good guy might be the bad guy. Leave your thoughts below so far on all of this. Do you think that Robin Lane is more of an MLMer rather than the preacher's wife and the Shabbat school teacher,
aka a multi-level magician?
Mine's a tale that can't be told. My freedom I hold dear. How years ago, in days of old, when magic filled the air, 'twas in the darkest depths of mortar, I met a girl so fair. But Gollum and the evil one crept up and slipped away with her, and it ain't nothing I can do. And no, no, I just keep on rambling. Rambling, it's a form of chaos magic, as words have power. God spoke the world in his creation into existence.
Confusion is of the enemy.
Rambling and Babylon, which is Babylon. Babylon, like Babylon in the Bible, Mystery Babylon. And every lyric in this Led Zeppelin song is coded with a sigil or some type of a magical spell, or it's backmasked.
Ramble.
Gotta keep searching for my baby. So creepy, talking about a literal May Queen ritual. Oh my, 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 yeah, I can't find my bluebird. I'd listen to my bluebird sing. Remember that, we're gonna come back to this. There are millions of songbirds dying all around the world shown, or I had the song pop in my head immediately after I looked this song up, because the magic on this stuff is dark and it takes a lot out of me. Anywho, it was a Bob Marley song, and it was that song, "Don't Worry About a Thing, 'Cause Every Little Thing Is Gonna Be Alright." Then it goes, "Woke up this morning, smiled at the rising sun. Three little birds appeared at my doorstep, singing sweet songs of melodies pure and true. Singing, I got this message for you, hoo hoo." Comment your thoughts below, guys. So that was three times I was shown something about songbirds. All right, so the meaning that I took from that was that A, definitely are doing the May Queen. There's a May Queen ritual spirit on all of these cases, because A, they're regarding children. And in the May Queen ritual, they take three children, two boys and a girl. The girl is the May Queen, and she is treated for the year before. They do it on the solstice. They do the May Queen, and then they have, in antiquity, these rituals. They've chosen the children prior to them even being born, before they're sacrificed, and they're given this beer with a plant-based hallucinogenic drug mixed in with it. This is from ancient times, guys. But my question is, has it ever stopped? Anyway, so what they would do would be, is they would choose three children, and the families of those people had no choice. And they were taken, and for 1 year they lived with the elites, and they dressed them nice. But the girl was treated the best because she was the May Queen. And again, like I said, they gave them beer laced with a plant-based hallucinogen. They fed them well up until the day of the ritual, which then they drugged. They knew how much they had to drug them to get them through the human sacrifice. And the reason I think the Bob Marley song popped into my head is because this is such dark magic and dark black magic and such evil. The Most High had to put a godly song on my spirit because Bob Marley was a prophet. If you listen to his music, everything that he spoke about in his album Exodus, he was a prophet of God. So, you know, the balance, if you're looking into dark things, I find that the Holy Spirit always leads me to look into something to balance it out. So the negative was rambling on, which is what multi-level media people do. They just ramble on. Do, 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 looking for my baby. How creepy is that, guys? And they're literally singing about the May Queen ritual to make it in Hollywood or to make it and become super famous. You got to do these rituals. These rituals are commonplace as you move up the levels in the pyramid, aka the Stairway to Heaven, aka the Tower of Babel, where all the languages were confused and no one could understand each other because God saw that they were trying to build a tower into heaven or a portal into heaven. And he confused their languages so they couldn't understand each other to finish building it because it wasn't time yet. But we're in that time now. We're in the time of the end of time. Not the end of life, but the end of the constraints of time. And the Tower of Babel. And babbling like a baby with their word salad. AKA rambling or babbling on to keep us in confusion. Leave your comments and your thoughts below. If you like this video and this type of content, give us a thumbs up, subscribe, and hit the notification key so you're alerted when we post our next video. And thanks for walking with me.